This is a paper which we are doing with Channing and Christ. It's about multidimensional poverty analysis for Tanzania, trying to use welfare indicators and apply first order dominance approach. And the sort of motivating is that we saw that it's well known that high economic growth will lead to poverty reduction. This is what happened in most parts of the world. But for the most countries in sub-Saharan Africa, including Tanzania, that is not what happened. For example, Tanzania has achieved very impressive macroeconomic performance, including economic growth, which has been growing at 70% since 2000 to date. And yet, poverty has not gone down that much significantly. And then people wonder, what is happening? Why are there a mismatch between high economic growth at one hand and still the level of poverty remains the same? And what we are trying to do here, we want to try to understand, is that because of what determines economic growth, or is that because we wrongly measure the poverty comparing to economic growth and the welfare indicators? And we are saying measuring poverty and reconciling with other indicators is really a very complex phenomenon. And although the poverty monetary, the $1 per day, give a very good insight of how things have been happening over time, that on its own has got a number of challenges and shortcomings. One is when you use poverty or monetary measures, it's not consistent over time and across space. That's number one. There are many, many challenges in terms of the methodologies, which I cannot go through here. But more than that, there is more to poverty than money. And therefore, poverty by nature is multidimensional. And we are saying, although measuring poverty using non-monetary measures, multidimensional, has a problem, yet that can give even much more a better and accurate assessment of what is poverty. And this is what we've been doing here. And we are saying that the main challenge of using many indicators measuring poverty is that it's quite difficult to do the so-called aggregating the welfare. So weighting is a problem. You have to put a lot of assumptions and the subjectivity, whether education is better than, whether education is important than health, or what is important than housing. And we are trying to use an approach which does not suffer much from that normative or subjectivity, which is the first order dominance, which in a simple way, it says it's better to be better, it's better to be not deprived than being deprived. If you have two populations, let's say year 1990 and 2000, and you have welfare indicators, you are trying to see whether the welfare in urban is better than in rural area. If you can do some sort of reallocation within the urban area, and yet urban areas tend to be better than the rural area, then you can confirm that people in urban are doing by far better than those in rural area. This is what we're trying to do. And we are doing so using Tanzania demographic health surveys. For this survey, we are defining four population categories: the households, the children, the under five, and the young women. And for each population categories, we are defining five welfare indicators. For instance, for the household, we define water, sanitation, shelter, education, and information. And what we are saying here, a household is not deprived from water if the source of drinking water is from pipe, a tap, or a well-protected well. And the household also is not deprived as far as sanitation is concerned if that the household is deprived in terms of sanitation if that household does not have a flush toilet or ventilated improved pit latrine. Also, we are saying that the household is deprived in terms of shelter if his or her house is constructed using the floor material which are either made of dead sun, dung, or planks. And in terms of education, household is deprived if the head of household has not got primary education, has not finished primary education. And in terms of information, if that household has no radio or TV. So those are the five welfare indicators we're using for at the household level or children. And we are starting by doing some simple distribution statistics here, trying to see what is happening with these five welfare indicators. So if we compare from 1992 to 2010, at the national level, we are seeing that with an exception of water, all other indicators have done very well. You see that in 1992, it's only 2% were the sanitation, improved sanitations. But by 2010, it's 11%. As far as shelter, it was only 18%. By 2010, it's around 30. By education, it's only 31. But by 2010, a big improvement, 56%. So the same can be said in terms of information. What really has not been improving is as far as the access to water. And that is very well known back in Tanzania. And the recent report shows that by 2025, the situation will be even worse. That there is rapid urbanization, and the government is not that much sharp to supply more water. This is as far as the five welfare indicators. And then we are trying to combine all this with welfare and see what happens if somebody is depriving all welfare indicators or is not deprived in all other indicators. And we are seeing that many people really exit out of poverty. It was 34% in 1992, now it's around 15%. The people were deprived in all welfare indicators. Those who were not, they were doing good in all indicators. It was only 1.6 in 1992. It's now 6.31. And these results compare very well with what we use in terms of monetary measures, because we see from 90 to 2007, poverty has gone down by only 5%. And here we are seeing those who have been doing very well, it's only a difference of 5%. So there's some more very close. But when you decompose further, you find that there's been a huge improvement for the rural area in terms of those who exit from the severe poverty, but more improvement in terms of in the urban area for those who are doing good in all indicators. That is what we see. And what it summarizes that poverty remains to be a rural phenomenon in Tanzania.
Thank you very much.